So then I'm ready to take off. Now I give you like this. And
just let that
come. So we give a few minutes to your anchor.
Good morning to one and all present of esteemed faculty members and all my dear friends. Today we all have gathered here for a guest lecture on exotic stars, black holes, wormholes and time travel. A black hole is a region of space-time exhibiting such a strong gravitational effect that nothing, not even particles and electromagnetic radiations such as light, can escape from inside it. To elaborate this, we have with us erudite Dr. Daya Shankar Kulshreshtha, along with Dr. Usha Kulshreshtha, Associate Professor, Kirodimal College, University of Delhi. Dr. Daya Shankar Kulshreshtha is a professor of theoretical physics at Delhi University, head of Department of Physics and Astrophysics at DU for a period of 3 years. Sir is a lecturer in physics at University of Delhi. He is also a guest editor of Nuclear Physics B Proceedings Supplement. He has also been a member of International Light Cone Advisory Committee. Sir has done research on topics like theoretical and mathematical physics, field theories, gravity theories and many more. Sir, I now request you to share your valuable experience with us.
A very, very good morning to everybody.
Morning.
I thank I do not know the name of the gentleman who introduced me. I assume he is one of the students or faculty at your age in the management. No.
This is he.
He is a student.
Okay. And your name, please.
Kartik
is a great name. So thank you, Kartik, very much for your very kind words, for introducing me. And before I begin anything, let me first express my very, very sincere thanks to the distinguished faculty, the management, the great university, RNBGU Global University, located at a very wonderful place called Bikaner. I am here for the very first time. Praveen ji, Misra ji, and many people whom I mean, not know by name. I thank everybody, the entire faculty. Then perhaps we could start talking on the things that I wish to present. My students at DU are my best friends, and the students all over the country and abroad, wherever I travel, my best friends are my students. So that's my best introduction, and you would know me a little bit better as we proceed along this topic. I would try to cover almost entire physics, not entire physics, but the basics of entire physics, almost I would need. So my main hobby, main interest is the fundamentals of physics, but you have to choose some particular topic, and you can proceed along the lines on a particular topic. So I have chosen this this topic called exotic stars, black holes, wormholes, time travel. I have been working on some of these things for the last about 7 years or so. I'm primarily a field theorist or a quantum field theorist, as you like. One of the most accurate theories of nature that we have known so far. And this is the relativistic quantum field theory. And I apply it to gravity, general relativity, And you will see what these exotic stars means. And Karthik already told you something about black holes. So similarly, there are something called as wormholes, which are also very, very interesting. And the wormholes could be converted into a time machine. Okay, that is our introduction of the summary to my topic. So, then what is a time machine? Time machine would be some kind of a machine or analogous to your aeroplane or analogous to your Apollos, in which you fly to maybe from New Delhi to Bikaner or to New York or London or Sydney or anywhere. That's a plane or a craft, or you fly to Moon or Mars. We have launched Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan, right? Some of you might have seen me on the TV explaining some of these things at the time of launch of these vehicles and their different various stages, right? When we took off from Earth, when we crossed the Earth's orbit to enter the a gravity field of some other object like Moon or Mars. So, I mean, the common language I'm using. And now, if I could think of another spacecraft, which would travel also in time, not only in space. So, for example, if I could travel 20 years backwards or 20 years forwards to see what happens to this bird, what is this bird? Or how would it look like 20 years later or 50 years ago when I was a little child? I think all of us would be extremely excited if such a thing could happen. So, the theory, theoretical physics in particular, the quantum field theory and the general theory of relativity, it allows us the time travel. So, you can travel backward and forward. Forward time travel has already been experimentally verified in the flights of these astronauts. Okay, maybe by few milliseconds, but nevertheless experimentally verified. Okay, so it's no longer hypothetical. Backward time travel has not yet been experimentally verified, but theory says it's perfectly fine, correct to do it. And you can do it. So it depends on the younger generation, younger people like you, okay, who have to take the studies forward and produce some interesting things, and maybe in your lifetime or maybe in future generations. But one should dream big, as the recent Miss World or Miss Universe, who is this? Everybody would know here, right? Manushi Childer. She says, dream big. So you have to dream big also in physics, also in academics. You decide you want to do this and you can do it. You have to determine, okay? So here we now take off on this very topic. I think I have told you on all of these topics a little bit, but we go gradually, okay? So I suppose I go up to 1 o'clock. Started at 11:30, right?
12:45.
You want to cut my 15 minutes? Well, okay. Because from the very beginning I have been insisting I need 90 minutes. So we started at 11:30. I will see if I can finish a few minutes earlier, but I can promise you will not be bored. You will say I should speak and
once
continue.
Once we are in a wormhole, the time will not be counted.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Even in the black hole, you black hole does not see the flow of time actually. Okay. All right. So then we are at this great place, Bikaner, and I don't know correctly if you call it Fort Gate or Fort Gate. Okay, yes. So I visited it on Saturday evening, and I found that it was well crowded and very, very vibrant, and lot of people, lot of activities were going on there. I even had some food and some sweets there. So I like it very much. And then we are now at this RN Bajaj Global University of Bikaner. That's a beautiful campus. And I very much like it. And as per the topic of my talk, there is a very famous quote from Mr. Pythagoras. Everybody could know Pythagoras? Yes, good. So Mr. Pythagoras said 2,500 years ago that the stars in the heavens sing a music only if they have ears to hear. Okay, it's very relevant and very inspiring. So we will make extensive use of some of his ideas. The ideas of Mr. Pythagoras. Okay. I will tell you very elementary things, even though you are not from deep physics or too much involved in physics, they would also understand what I am talking. Okay. My aim is to motivate all of you to see what is available to us in the universe, what is there on the menu card. Okay. Then you have the appetite. So good. Now, this is still December 2017. Exactly 2 years ago, we celebrated 100 years of the general theory of relativity or general relativity, called by both the names. And just 1 year later, after the general relativity march came into existence, okay, it was some month of November or so, Mr. Einstein and Mr. David Hilbert, they were working back and forth on the understanding of the